Reset and Revealing, Part 2. For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creation eagerly waits for the revealing of the sons of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not willingly, but because of him who suggested it, who subjected it in hope. Because the creation itself also will be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. According to the scriptures, there is coming a day when there will be a disclosure, a revealing, a removal of cover of the sons of God. Since there is going to be a revealing of God's sons, the question is, what will the revealing reveal? And what will this manifestation manifest? When the revealing and manifestation of God's sons take place, I want to be certain that I will be revealed in him and by him. As I ponder and look forward to this drawing near of the full revelation of God's kingdom, I want to approach these days with eyes wide open. Paul, the apostle, uses these words to describe his attitude and the attitude of the believer. What things were gained to me? These things I have counted loss for Christ. Yet indeed, I also count all things lost for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness which is from God by faith, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his death, if by any means I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. It is my fervent belief and goal to be found in him, not having my own righteousness, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness which is from God by faith, that I may know him. It is my strong belief that in these times we must rely not on ourselves, nor on our own righteousness, our self-taught righteousness, but that which is of God. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that, denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in the present age, looking for the blessed hope and glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from every lawless deed and purify for himself his own special people, zealous for good works. This reset for the Lord's people is reorientation of direction and priorities, which cannot be faked in any way, but is totally dependent on the Holy Spirit's involvement in every moment of our life. Can you imagine what it must have been like as Jesus sat on the Mount of Olives, reorienting his disciples, telling them astounding things concerning things near and far, things which concerned the certain destruction of Jerusalem and thus the nation of Israel, and of his coming again, and of the end of the age, an age which concerns us right now as we live and breathe and make our plans for tomorrow. He was not only talking to them that day, but to all who in every generation has ear to hear, even to us now as we listen to his voice in this very moment. Pastor Don.